Hi everyone, hope you all are doing great. So Mansi and I are representing Galboss Inn. Galboss Inn is a volunteer-led initiative which is focused on helping young women take more mindful decisions around career and life. Today we are here with yet another episode of Real Women, Real Stories, and we welcome Kimaya. Today, after completing her master's degree, she worked as a PR executive for 2 years and is now a professor at the Department of Media and Communication at Ferguson College, Pune. Thank you so much for joining us, Kimaya. It's really
thank you so much, Sonu, for inviting me.
So, Kimaya, as you know, our theme for this conversation is resilience, and we would like to know more about your story. So before we start with our conversation, I would like my co-host Mansi to take us through an icebreaker rapid fire round. So over to you, Mansi.
Hi, I'm so glad you decided to join us. Let's get started with the rapid fire. So I'll say a word and you tell me the first thing that comes to your mind when I say the word.
Okay, Mansi.
Okay, strength.
My mom.
Pain.
Pain. It heals. Give
Woman.
It time, it heals.
Woman.
Power. Power.
Resilience.
Everyone has it. You need to find it from yourself.
Okay, and Galboss Inn.
It talks about a young woman and it's going to represent young women, so it's trending.
Thank you
so much for that. So Kimaya, what does it mean to you about being resilient? I would like to know more about your story.
For me, resilience was taught by my mother when I was very young. So I'll tell you an incident what happened in my life. I was a slow learner when I was a kid from my primary school. So for me, writing and reading was very difficult. At the same time, for me, math was okay, but especially any language, to grasp a language, it was very difficult for me. So my mother knew that I'm a slow learner, but then she thought I'll cope up. Slowly I'll cope up, because my understanding of academics was very different than what others were doing. And first 3 years of my school was very nice. I had got very good class teacher who used to help me with this with my academics, and she would support me every time. And I was in an international school where culture difference was also hampering me, because I was trying to cope up with the culture what the students were coming from, because they were coming from all over the world. They were just not from Pune, from all over the world. So for me to cope up with them was very difficult. And at the same time, these started bullying me. My classmates started bullying me because I was not able to read and write like them. And I used to always get zero in every test that I had in my class. And they used to make fun of it. And I used to hide this from my mother. And my mother used to feel, okay, she's doing okay. She'll be fine soon. She never shouted at me ever that why are your grades so less, or why are you not able to read and write. But she used to help me with it every single day. So one fine day, I was promoted to my fourth standard, where I met this teacher of mine. She was quite old, somewhere in her 40s or 50s, and so she was new to me. I was new to her. And this lady understood that I'm not able to read and write. So she didn't tell my mother, but she immediately shifted me to a slow learner class. A slow learner class where they were special abled children were studying there. And she had put me there. So she thought that I'm a special child. I am not a normal person, or I'm not a normal kid who can be taught normally. If I have been taught properly, I will be able to cope up with others. She thought that I will not ever be able to study, read, write, or give my 10th standard also. So she didn't tell my mother about this, and she shifted me to a slow learner class. And over there, I was in a shock because I lost my sense, my classmates. People started making fun of me because I was in a normal class and suddenly I was shifted to a special abled child, classroom where I was not taught anything, doing nothing, just doing sketching, drawing, that's it. And then my mother understood this. And then what is to my teachers to do? So I used to feel that, okay, if I take off all my things to that class, then I will lose my connection with my class. So I used to keep my bag in my classroom. And I used to always come, the period used to shift. So I used to come in between, take my book and go again to that class. And in that period, one time I saw there was a free lecture and the teacher was sitting and there were all students around her standing and they were giggling. Huh? And I was not understanding what exactly. I felt very jealous because obviously having your classmates enjoying and you're not being part of it. I felt so bad about it. And they saw me and they stopped giggling. And I was like, why stopped suddenly giggling? Why are they not talking? I mean, I never thought they are talking about me. Am I that important for them? They were talking. Then I understood later on, my teacher was telling them that this girl is not normal. She is special child and she'll be not in your class. She's not able to read and write. She'll be the one who will be not able to give her 10th standard in with you guys. And she'll be left behind. My best friend left me that day. And I felt so bad. I was bullied every day in school. I was being told that you are a Maharashtrian. Why are you in this school? Go to some Marathi school. Your mother speaks Marathi. Your mother wears a sari. Why you are put in this school? Don't you understand? You have a very different schools. Why you have come into this international school? And I used to always feel why my mother has put me in this school. Why she is trying to, put me in this torture and this trauma that I'm going every single day. As a child, I was in a depression. And it was later I started showing in my eating habits, in my behavior. I started getting scared for any small things. And my mother understood there's something wrong with her. She came to school one fine day. She just observed me what I'm doing. And then she spoke to the person whom I was put into a special. I told you I was put in a special class. So she met that teacher of mine. She asked her what exactly is wrong with her. Will she not able to give her 10th standard or will she will not able to cope up with others? So that teacher told my mother that she will able to cope up. Only thing that we need to give a little more attention than others. Like a teacher every single day, small words, how to read. She'll be able to cope up and she'll be normal like normal student. It's only thing that her basics are not clear and she's not taught properly or maybe she's not given that much attention by the school in her primary. So my mother's like, will you able to help me out with this? I will take it at home and even you take in school and let's see in this 6 months how she copes up. My mother brought me home. She's like, see, Himaya, you have only 6 months in your hand. You want to prove yourself that you are a normal child and you will able to read and write properly. I was like, yes, mom, I will do anything. Whatever you tell me, I'll do everything. I just want to get out of this because every single day I'm going into a trauma and I'm not liking it. Or I want to leave school. I don't want to go to school at all. I hate studies now because I started hating studies. So my teacher and my mother used to every single day take my reading, my spellings. And I'll tell you, not 6 months, in 2 months, I started reading properly, I started writing properly. My mother literally took the, she told the class teacher, you gave her the question paper, what you're giving to a normal child, let her solve. Let's see how much marks she gets. And then we will decide what to do. And I scored like in 80s. And everyone was sure that I can do it. So my mom was like, immediately you have to start show your thing. That you don't have to just wait and sit and just cry for it. That, oh, but I'm not able to do it. My mother changed my school. I went to a convent school after that. And I'll tell you, in my 10th standard, I scored 90% and I was not that slow learner anymore. I still remember that day. In this lockdown also, I was just thinking about my past, my school days, and I really feel I want to meet that teacher one more. And I would tell her that what you did was extremely wrong. I'm a teacher right now. I know there are students, even in their college, they are very slow, or maybe they're not so perfect with studies, but doesn't mean that I have to judge them. I have to, make fun of them or not support them, because that is not going to give them anything. Only it's going to hamper their mental state and they will start hating studies, which I don't want that to happen. So as a teacher, yes, I have learned to be having patient support and to be with every student and make that friendly relationship than, being a strict, disciplined teacher. So this is what I have learned in my life.
Wow. I mean, hearing your story, I'm like, wow. And, just knowing about your experiences and that too at such an early age, right, where it is difficult for ourselves to really understand what is going on around. And then when you have to really tackle a situation where people are actually giggling, and a teacher is a part of that situation. I mean, teacher is a part of that entire situation that is going on. And it is so, even if it is just one person who is bullying you, it is so difficult. And over here, it's the entire class.
It's the whole class and the teacher bullying me. And it was not only one time that she did it. She was to do it every single time. And I was a joke of the class. People used to push me. They used to, because I was not given respect by my teacher. Why would other students will give me respect? I was being pushed from the staircase. I was being hit. I was being bit by the students. My tiffin used to be being thrown in the dustbin. I mean, all sort of things they had done. And when I went to the teacher, she never, she started laughing on my face that all this is happening with me. So it was, okay, what I have told you is not that serious what I told you. But if I tell you one incident, it is so, right now, so for me, it's so, I feel so bad about it. I want to meet that teacher right now. I know she must be too old, because that time only she was somewhere in her 50s and now 30 years, like it's past. I really want to meet her.
Okay, I mean, first of all, I would like to tell you that I feel so proud of you. I mean, realizing...
Thank you so much.
Yeah, realizing that. And of course, hats off to your mom, who really helped you in your journey. And, for being in fourth grade, understanding that, yes, I want to come out of it. So I would just like to know a bit more about what was that feeling like when you decided that, yes, I want to come out of it. And what really happened in those 2 months that made you, that brought in that transformation from being a slow learner to being
one thing, I wanted to be normal like others. That was the one thing that came in my mind. I want to be normal. I don't want to be like I don't have to be treated special. I'm not special. I'm a normal child. I have some problems in me, but I can cover that. I can, my mistakes could be improved. Second, in that 2 months, my teacher, she started made me love studies. So I used to hate it. So she started making me feel that you can do it, you can read it. So when I used to see a word, I used to get scared. I used to feel this is not, I cannot read this. I will not able to read my whole life. But when she told me, no, you will able to. So when I started seeing the letters together, then I felt, no, I have to do it. I can do it. I know this is what I have to do. I have to be normal. I have to prove myself normal. I have to read. So it was amazing, the journey. Still, I remember her. When I just closed my eyes, I remember that teacher sitting in front of me, that young teacher. Obviously, she must be old now. The young teacher sitting in front of me and teaching me and telling me to read. And she used to make charts, a graded chart there today, how many words you read in 1 minute? Okay. Is it 50 words? Okay, today's 50. Tomorrow, 1 minute, how many words you're reading? 60. So, okay, you're progressing. So, my progress report was front of me. So, it was she and me in just a normal 100 square feet of room where only she and me were just doing. Having food together, morning 8 o'clock we used to start, evening 4 o'clock we used to leave the room. And I used to not even have my lunch. I decided not to have lunch with my friends also. Just be with her, understand the whatever she's teaching me. She didn't even teach me study. She taught me many other things, you know, to be a woman, to be a girl, and to accept the way you are.
Right.
Stop judging yourself.
Exactly. And, you know, the best part that I liked about it is, you know, that determination that, you know, shows up on your face. That, yes, I decided that I want to be normal.
I decided.
Right. So that determination. But just one thing, there, what I was thinking of when you were, you know, explaining or telling me your story was, it is also about coming out of your comfort zone. So when you said that I was not able to see all the letters together. So, you know, coming out of the comfort zone, how important it is. So at times when we see a difficult situation, we just try to get away with it or try to escape, right? But when we actually face it, that is the real challenge, or that is when the real story begins.
Right.
And once
I was scared of the letters. I was scared of books. I was scared of sentences. I was scared of paragraphs. You just tell me, I was scared. I used to shiver. Maybe I knew how to read it, but I was scared of it. So,
And at times it becomes important. So thinking of your teacher who was your class teacher then, who shifted you to another class, there is one more thing that just comes to my mind, is sometimes it really takes a hard, you know, situation or a difficult thing to happen to you to really, you know, strike that thing that, yes, I want to change things. I cannot be in this situation anymore. I cannot keep escaping
anymore.
I want to I want to have that face off. So coming across, or when life gets you to that situation and you decide that, yes, this is it. Now I need to work. There is no more escaping.
Yes. Escaping from this. I have to learn or I don't have to learn. I have to understand what I have to do. I mean, where I have to reach in my life.
Right.
So, yes, I did.
Yeah, so I mean, it is a great, I mean, hearing about your experiences, I'm sure, you know, your story is that of determination, willpower, and coming out of your comfort zone.
Yeah.
And, and we see how, you know, so once when it was difficult for you as a student, now you are making it easy for your students.
Easy for my students, yeah.
Right. So I really love it. I'm sure, you know, people watching this or listening to you would love hearing you and would surely
Thank
get something
so
to implement in their lives. So, yeah.
Thank you so much.
What advice would you like to give to younger women who are trying to get through life and their struggles?
One thing I have seen in young women is that how much ever you, women, young women say that, okay, I'm very practical, I'm very modernized, I'm very feminist. No, they are not. At times now, they limit themselves in the four walls of society that society has made. And you start judging yourself at times because the society is judging you. The way you look, the way you wear, the way you, what you're doing. I mean, even you're studying, they judge you. And stop judging yourself. If you stop judging yourself, you will find change in yourself. And the change will bring power. And live your life on your own terms. Seriously, I'm living my life on my own terms, and I'm enjoying. I'm very happy with this. If I limit myself, if I start, understanding this is what society wants from me, then I will not ever in my life be happy. Stop doing that, because every girl goes from that, even if she's from a modern family or even she's from a conservative family. Society is the one that is binding her from everything. Stop thinking about that. And just live your life.
That is some great advice.
Yes. I mean, I loved what you said. And we really, I mean, all the young girls out there really need to hear what you said. because that's very important, and that is one thing that we really want our our young women to know and really implement in their lives to just
if we start changing the society, it will take time. It's better we start changing ourselves and stop judging ourselves,
which is true, right? So, I mean, it was a great conversation, Kimaya. I mean, I'm sure
it was fun. For me, it was also fun.
Yeah,
it's a long time I'm speaking about this.
Yeah, it's so good to hear, and we want more people to talk about this, so our young women know about this, right? So thank you so much for joining us, Kimaya.
Thank you so much, Hansi and Sonu. Yeah, it was great talking to you. Bye. See you.
Bye.